Hey guys, here on episode 98, and we're talking about increasing your marketing through speed, hard work, and swagger. Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome to the 88 Show. This is the internet's only dental show where we talk about what matters most in marketing. I am your host, Joshua Scott. We're here on a Monday morning shooting episode 98, man, getting close to 100 episodes in the books. So excited for that. But this month we got a new topic. We're talking about hustle marketing, specifically a formula for hustle. And I think what's interesting is this week we're gonna hit on this show, but then 2 weeks coming back on episode 99, I've got a really special guest, Michael Arias, the ground marketer, the dental marketer. He's gonna be here with us talking about ground marketing, what that is, what that looks like. Super great guy. I'm really excited to get that out there and share with you that. But what was interesting is when I got into this topic, because I actually talk about hustle marketing a lot, and I have before on the show. And for me, the concept is like, look, marketing is momentum. And so it's momentum. It needs this like force to get it going. And the two things that really get marketing like going and push it are either A, just energy, like hustle, like getting out there and just making it happen, or B, money. So you can either put a budget behind marketing and that pushes it and gets it moving, or you can just put straight energy behind it and get out there and hustle and that gets it moving as well. And so, you know, we go through these phases of professional life and career and practice seasons. Sometimes you don't have much money, so we gotta get out there and hustle to make it happen. And then other times things are so busy, you're trying to focus clinically and you don't have the time to get out there and hustle and do the community events like you used to. And so you just start putting a little bit more money behind it to push it. Either way is fine, but today let's talk about hustle marketing and what that is, okay? What's really interesting is go on to Instagram right now and just put in hashtag hustle, right? Like as I was starting to write this article, I was like, let me kind of get a feel for what people are saying about hustle out there in the world, because it's definitely a buzzword. And man, you put that in all the hashtags that come up. I mean, hustle life, hustle boss, hustle hard, hustle harder, hustle and flow, hustle town. Like it just never stops. And as you look on Instagram, you realize that people use the word and use the hashtag to validate, you know, what they've got going on and almost put their stamp of approval on it. Like, yo, I'm working hard, I'm hustling, making it happen. And so it kind of is all over the board on what it means, but I want to kind of focus in on what would it mean to hustle in marketing? What does our marketing look like? And so to do that, to talk about it, let me first bring to you a quote by the famous American poet 50 Cent. He was recently quoted in an Esquire magazine, who, by the way, he clarified, he said it's 50 Cent, not 50, which I think is real helpful. So 50 Cent said, "I never saw drug use as a good option. I'd rather have an additional $10 than smoke. It wasn't a decision to not smoke weed. It was a decision to hustle. It was a business decision. Hustling was my internship." So here's 50 Cent growing up in Chicago and saying that his decision not to smoke weed wasn't about doing drugs. It was a business decision. It was a decision to put himself first. It was a decision to hustle and to make sure he gave himself every opportunity to succeed. It was hustling. So let's talk about what hustle marketing looks like in a dental practice. All right, so let's define what hustle marketing is. We're gonna put together a little bit of an equation here, three parts, and the first one is that hustle equals speed. So when we're talking about hustle marketing, it's about being in the right places and taking advantage of the right opportunities at the right time. That whole concept of being first to market is definitely an advantage. And so whether it's a social media platform, you know, those of you who jumped in on Facebook, you know, 5-10 years ago are feeling the advantage of that now because you've got 1,000 followers or 5,000 followers or whatever. Or being into like a local community magazine that's that's coming into the area and being one of the first people in it, there's definitely an advantage to being quick into new opportunities and new areas. It's also about efficiency with dollars and ad campaigns, you know, which is why sometimes getting locked into like a 12-month contract or a 24-month contract with some companies, a lot of times traditional advertising wants to lock you down for that long. It's not to your advantage because you don't have the speed to move quick if something were to change. It's also about thinking long term, the next year, 3 years, 5 years in your marketing plan and your budget so that you don't waste money and you can connect all the pieces together. Sometimes, honestly, speed is about slowing down to come up with a plan. Like get the branding right first, get the website right first, like do all these things that you can connect and build on in a way that builds this amazing structure that you don't have to go back and rebuild. So speed in your marketing, all about efficiency and taking advantage of opportunities. All right. Number two is hard work. What hard work here for me is, man, when we're talking about hustle marketing, it's the 1% more that nobody else is doing, right? It's the extra social media posts. It's the going live on Facebook when you don't feel like it. It's all the little extra every day. That 1%, man, in the beginning looks real small, but over the course of a year, over the course of 5 years, 10 years, it's a huge difference to the competition. All right, for me, the second thought here is it's sweating the details. It's sweating through all those details. Like, what is the call to action here? What is the personality and the voice of the brand? Like taking time to define that. What does our brand sound like? And then making sure it's consistently following those voices, that personality every single time. So that consistency. And then last, man, it's just being smart. It's being disciplined and smart in your marketing strategy. It's sitting down at the end of an amazing year to work on next year's marketing plan. Even though the year was awesome, you're like, look, we gotta sit down, put in the hard work, put together a marketing plan and execute it for next year. We're not getting lazy. We're not gonna ease up because everything's good, right? And so that's hard work, man. Sweating the details, doing the extra 1% to make sure your marketing gets ahead. And then last in our kind of 3-point formula here is hustle is swagger. It's swagger. And here's what I mean by that. It's that raw confidence of knowing, man, what we do is the best, and I want everybody to experience that. It's making bold statements about your practice and your quality of care because you know that you live up to that. It's not arrogant, it's this compelling confidence that's leading the way and saying, hey, follow me. Right? It's based on like dozens of reviews and patient experiences that you know that you've got right. It's not based on the small percentage of failures that you've had or inconsistent experiences or unmet expectations. It's based on what you do best and how you've delivered that time and time again and all the patient stories and testimonials that back it up. And so it's knowing, man, we got a killer patient experience, we got a killer practice, a killer team, and I want you to experience that. So that's what swagger is. It's that holding your head up high confidence to move forward in your marketing that compels new patients to check you out. All right, guys, as you can imagine, talking about hustle marketing and defining that is a ton of fun. Clearly, my equation is not the end all for that conversation. I'd love to hear your thoughts as well on what you think hustle marketing looks like. Before I go, one major favor you could do is go to iTunes. You'll find the link down below. Leave me a review on this podcast. 98 episodes in, man, I'm not asking for much, but if you found any value in this, I'd love for you to go leave me a review. It's literally the only way people find this podcast is the reviews and the downloads, the subscriptions. So you can help me out there. Article this month, the link is down below, A Formula for Hustle. Next episode, Michael Arias, the dental marketer, is gonna be here. Super excited about that. And last, gotta get out of here, but hit me up on Instagram @Joshua Scott. Would love to hear your comments. Guys, until next time, I'll see you then.